Hey guys, for those of you that didn't see yesterday's video, if you go onto Facebook, it's like down, it's the one down there. I hope I'm pointing to it. But anyways, I did a first video on Psalm 27. Basically, I'm going to be going over the Psalms in my own quiet time and preparation for worship on Sunday. But I'm also going to share it with you guys and share the stuff that I'm reading. So today I'm covering Psalm 29, again, like I said in yesterday's video, at church, Epic Church, we're going over a new series. It's called The Writer, The Warrior and The Writer, and, completely based off of the life of David. And, but anyways, I'm going over, Psalms on my own as well. And I'm going to share that with you guys and kind of give you guys an encouragement for the day. Today we're going to go over Psalm 29. Psalm 29 goes like this. It says, "Ascribe to the Lord, O mighty ones, ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness." So really quick, that word ascribe, it's to give credit to, right? Is to give credit to God for who he is. Not necessarily for what he does, just who he is, giving him the glory for who he is. So it has been something that I'm adjusting today in my own worship. You know, I start off sometimes, you know, just leading off in prayer and thanking God for all the things that he's done for me, which is fantastic, and I continue to do so. But thinking a little bit differently today, starting off with ascribing to the Lord the glory, do his name. Just giving him the glory for who he is, right? It's saying, ascribe to the Lord the glory, do his name, worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. You know, just taking the time to worship God, again, for who he is and not for what he does necessarily. Just taking the time to stay still, to enjoy him in the splendor of his holiness, right? If you go down Psalm 29, you start to see... It describes the voice of the Lord being powerful and majestic and big, right? And it shakes the desert, right? In verse 8, you know, our God is big. Our God is majestic. Our God is holy. And so basically for today, before you come before the throne, before you pray, before you approach God, really take the time to think and just reflect and sit on how big he really is and how we should approach him. Basically, don't approach him flippantly today. Take the time to bow down to him as king. Give him the glory for who he is and then go from there. So a new way for me of approaching God. And sometimes I just forget, you know, just start thanking him. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And I forget that that he is holy, that he is the king, that he is mighty, that he is majestic, right? So that's all I got for you guys today. I hope you have an amazing day. Continue to worship. Just worship God today for who he is. Not necessarily for what he's done, but just for the fact that he is God. And he's a holy, holy God, deserving of all praise and adoration. All right, guys. Have a good day. I will see you soon.
Peace.
Oh, I'm going to drink my coffee.
It's good.